money is always one thing that will move people, yeah. right? So understanding that it's projected the podcast industry is a $100 billion industry by 2028.
Whoa. $100 billion?
Hey,
saying we need to continue to be podcasters. You out here.
By compound annual growth rate, the stat was produced by Grand Valley View Research. I can send y'all the link. But 94.88. Okay.
Okay, that's fair.
But that's 100 billion. That's closer to 100 than one, you know what I'm saying? So that's one part for the people who with the numbers. But also you can literally build your authority from nothing.
Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show with Jonathan Jones. Here you will learn how to start, launch, and monetize your podcast. In addition to hearing the latest trends and the latest and greatest things happening in the podcast industry. Are you ready?
What's going on, family? It's your podcast mentor, Jonathan Jones. And about a month or so ago, I ran into Nicky and Moose holding it down at Podcast Movement. They were holding it down at the Ecamm Live booth, and actually, I sat down with them and they flipped the script and I got to be interviewed by Nicky and Moose. So I took this clip and I wanted to share it with you all because I felt it was a lot of value and I felt it really could help a lot of people. So I wanted to just share it with you all. So I wanted to come in, just let you all know what you're going to come into and what you have access to. But in addition to that, enjoy it. Comment down below if you're watching on YouTube. And then feel free also to tag Nicky and Moose. Let them know you enjoyed the questions. Let them know you rock what they're doing. Or check them out if you haven't heard of them before. But if you haven't heard of them, you're under rock.
Okay, so what is there a session that you're still looking forward to? Or are you just happy that you're just around here? What's the vibe you got?
Yeah, so actually yesterday, just learning about audio storytelling.
Mm.
Like, and it was, I think the term was binaural. Exactly. I was like, what? Because they started talking about the Wolverine podcast. And, yeah, like with the Wolverine. We good?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool. But, yeah, they're talking about the Wolverine podcast and how when you listen with these certain headphones, you know, how you don't have to be as descriptive talking about, like, there's a tiger walking in front of you or something's dropping behind you because you hear it. And I'm like, what in the world? But this is a session I never would have attended. I wouldn't have looked it up, but just because I was working the room, helping in the techno track, I was like, okay, y'all talking good. Y'all talking real good in here.
Whoa. For my speakers, for my coaches, for my consultants, hold the phone, all right? So look, I know you're out there and I know you're in a spot to where you're tired of trying to do all of these things just to get in front of more people, all right? Here's the first way, the old way that we've been going about doing things, right? Going live Monday through Friday, videos constantly, this and that. That just don't work anymore. And it's gonna burn you out. And then next, my consultants, we're calling and we're trying to get everybody and anybody on a free consultation. They're our target audience or they're not. But now you're starting to lose confidence because you're virtually giving your business away. We can't do business like that anymore. And then lastly, my speakers. You want to speak on all the stages. You're going to speak anywhere. And then you're in the spot to where you're speaking. And then the only thing you're leaving with is a free chicken basket. Oh, no. So look, I have a free training, right? I put together a free training to help you get to the yes, right? So I put together this training and I'm gonna show you my 4P strategy, all right? And my 4P strategy, what it's gonna break down is gonna help you become the authority in your industry and help you cut down on having to do all of this so we can just skip right to this. All right, so don't wait, don't hesitate. Click the link right just down below. I'm gonna see you in the training because it's time to cut down the rat race and just start getting to the paper chase. See you in the training.
Okay, so let's talk about volunteering real quick because some people don't know that's like the hack. If you wanna go somewhere, you should volunteer. You get in pretty much free and you get the information. You gotta work a little bit. Like a lot of it, but still you get a lot of information. Talk about like the benefits of volunteering and kind of getting in those rooms. Have you met somebody that you were like, Hold on. And this is just any event. This doesn't necessarily have to be this event.
Yeah, for sure.
But, like, you met somebody, you're like, oh, snap, I didn't expect this. And I'm so happy.
Yeah, so in terms of volunteering, it's one of those things that, you know, it's service, right? Yeah. And it's not always the sexiest, but I've got the opportunity to meet people who are on stages like Dave Jackson, Podcaster Hall of Fame, and I was, you know, I got to meet him by volunteering. But even in addition to that, you get to, one, you get the opportunity to showcase and spotlight other individuals. But then also, I was talking with one of the gentlemen, he's head product manager. He was like, yeah, man, send me an email. I'll shoot you a free unit. And I was like, wait, what? He was like, yeah, let me know what you think about it. Senior marketing director.
Wow.
So, yeah, when they was like, whoa, that's day one. That's how we kicking it off, man.
Right. I get free stuff in day one?
Off the bat.
Yeah, so one, you get the opportunity to, you know, you could come away with something free, maybe, maybe not, but really understanding that when you begin to develop authentic relationships with people, keep the conversation going. You can even see opportunities of where, okay, there might be a gap here, might be a gap there. I can help here, I can help there. And then that's how you create relationships. That's how you create further opportunity. But, you know, really it's positioning yourself by, I don't want to say by lessening your position, but positioning yourself by serving other people.
That's pretty cool. What about podcasting do you like? Like, what part of podcasting to you? You said a podcast mentor. That means like, I've made a commitment to this industry. What about it? Do you find interesting, or what gravitates you toward it? You know, why should people who don't have a podcast today consider saying, maybe I need to start hit record and get going out there?
Yeah. Okay. Well. One, you know. Money is always one thing that will move people, right? So understanding that it's projected the podcast industry is a $100 billion industry by 2028.
Whoa. $100 billion?
Hey,
saying we need to continue to be podcasters? You out here.
By compound annual growth rate, the stat was produced by Grand Valley View Research. I can send y'all the link. But not 94.88.
Okay, that's fair.
But that's 100 billion. We closer to 100 than one. You know what I'm saying? So that's one part for the people who with the numbers. But also, you can literally build your authority from nothing. And for instance, we'll take you two as an example. You all didn't build your authority from nothing, but you all had areas of interest and areas to where you all have spent time. And then now with you all doing the podcast, y'all began to show people, look, check out these brands. These are things that we've taken away. And people are tapping in. I see the YouTube. Y'all what, 11K?
You know, 11.2. Yeah, man.
So it's the opportunity to create the authority, to create the lane, the thing to where you're calling out your tribe. You're calling them out by name. You're like, hey, this is what you're interested in. We're going to do this. When y'all talked about the pivot clips,
yes.
I heard Nicky say, hey, y'all love when we do the pivot clips. So, hey, we're going to break down the pivot a little bit more.
Shout out to the pivot, because the pivot's here, too. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The executive producer and I think not them, but the producers of here. Yeah, they're here.
Yeah. That's fair. As they should be.
Right.
So, and then the other part, connecting with other people, connecting with, you know, people who, you know, you look up to, connecting with people that you might want to be where they are. Mm-hmm. Podcasting is the best way to, you know, get that coaching, get that connection, and even get them on the show. Yeah. So, you know, like doing and putting all those things together, it's a recipe for any industry. We talk about corporate, we talk about personal brands, whatever. McDonald's had a podcast.
Yep.
Wow.
And McDonald's had a podcast about this Szechuan sauce, I believe it was. They had like a 6-episode series, and they were talking about the sauce because the sauce was getting ready to come back. So they were doing a product launch.
Yo, you know what's crazy, and I'm glad you mentioned this because I heard it in the room yesterday, that we think podcasts have to be a gazillion episodes.
Oh, man.
Bro,
yeah,
there are
yeah.
some podcasts that are six, eight episodes.
Yep.
Now, I'm not sure what they do after that. I don't know if they bring it back or they do another, like, season to it.
Mm-hmm.
But just the thought around, there are no rules. And I don't know why in our minds we create these rules and boundaries as to why we can't engage or why we can't enter, when in reality, you can do whatever you want, really.
Say, I'm about to blow your mind, Moose. I was looking at a guy named Frank Kern. You all might have heard of him. He connected with, like, Grant Cardone.
Yeah, yeah.
If you look, he got one-minute episodes, two-minute episodes, taking little clips that he's done from a call, from wherever he might have been. But, bro, people are getting real creative. And then Shans is doing, like, the five-minute Fridays.
Yeah.
To where he's doing different type of content. So it's... Man, a lot of people get boxing, especially people who might be outside, who either aren't in this space or they're thinking about getting this space. There's a lot of barriers there, but people who are in the space, we have to really take time and get creative about how do we want to leverage our podcast, what do we want it to do, and then we need to start doing the type of content that's going to produce those results.
Wow.
Okay, so what's your take? You know, YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
Did their little podcast platform, not calling it little, all right?
Yeah.
But they have a whole section, youtube.com/podcast, where now they're curating more and more of the podcast mm-hmm. clips, the episodes, the playlists, things like that. What is your thoughts about that from a video standpoint when it comes to podcasting?
Well, I mean, y'all talked about it. You got one. You got to do video.
Talk about it.
You got to do video. You got to do video, but two, if we see YouTube doing something, they're telling us we should be.
Yeah, that's a good point.
We need to be in that YouTube bag, right? So, if you haven't been doing video, start like today, like start right now. Just take a look, take the phone, do whatever you got to do, and just start documenting something. Because if you're not doing videos, and that means you're not doing shorts. If you're not doing shorts, then you're not trying to get discovered.
Wow. Wow.
They're saying share your podcast name again. Share your podcast name again.
Yeah, so the name of my podcast is Your Podcast Mentor Show. You can type in Your Podcast Mentor on YouTube and I'll pull up. Yeah.
Okay, let's start about maybe some beginning stuff. Like, what do people need, mm-hmm. right, when starting a podcast? Hey, hold on. We got Super Chat. Shout out to Chris. Shout out to Nick. I saw you in the Super Chat before. So, but yeah, what do people need to start a podcast? Because how we started, we got expensive mics. I don't think we're the greatest. We went all in. That we are extremists. Well, I am an extremist, and I kind of influenced him to be one. So what would you say if, hey, I'm thinking about starting a podcast.
Uh-huh.
I know I need to get equipment.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure what.
Yeah.
And the budget type wise, Nicky and Moose got $400, $500 mics. Do I need to get that? Then I heard I got to get a Rodecast. Like, talk to people.
Oh, Lord. Yeah. So, okay. So I'll give two examples. One, you can go to Earn Your Leisure Route, how they started out. The iPhone with the earphones, with the mic jack, right? Because we all, more likely, we all have a cell phone. Not we all. If we're from a place of, okay. Cell phone.
Majority of us.
Thank you, Nikki.
Well,
so, you know, cell phone with the earphones with the mic jack, right? That right there, you can get video, and then you can, you know, you can extract the audio from there. Or if we're like, okay, John, I'm a little bit more serious, you can get the Samsung 9, the Samsung. I get it confused because I got the Q2 Samsung. So it's the Samsung phone. It's the Samsung mic, and it's like, it was $59, but I think they raised it like to $79. You can get that and get started. It's a USB mic, so you can plug it right into your laptop and then just rock. Like right there, get started. And then, you know, you can host on Anchor. I don't recommend Anchor per se.
Okay, let's talk about it because I say the same thing, but
okay.
You're the podcast mentor, so
okay.
Why you say that?
So I don't recommend Anchor just because of the fact that you have to go through loops and bounds to be able to access like the analytics, and then they take the people who sign up, they put all their stuff together so that they can go get the sponsorships and they can go get and control how much you're gonna get. So, you know,
AKA not really ownership.
Yeah, it's definitely not ownership, because they set up a third party situation, which, you know,
it's good information right here. Yesterday we talked about mistakes, man. You know, 100 episodes in, we've had our fair share. You know, just from your journey, what are some mistakes that you can look back on and say, well, yeah, essentially it was a lesson, but shoot, if I go back, I might want to do this a little bit differently.
Not getting clear on what I wanted my podcast to do for me. My first podcast was called the Jonathan Jones Speaks Podcast, which wasn't necessarily bad, but it was geared towards millennials. But I was trying to speak at colleges more. Therefore, one thing I tell my clients all the time, I say, you got to look at who's your target audience. Audience of one, right? Focus on that one person you're talking to. But then on the other side, who's your target client? Because if we're catering to a target audience, this is the people who's listening, who's rocking. But then if we have a target client, this is somebody who could be a potential sponsor, right? Somebody who could be a listener as well as they could do business with you. But if we don't get clear on those two aspects, and ultimately it falls on the umbrella of what's the purpose of your podcast? You want it to help you establish authority? You want it to help you generate leads? You want it to help you make some money?
Yeah.
You want to do it for fun? You can do it for fun. You know, the Pivot. They doing it for fun. They rocking. But they making bread, though.
Nah, but they're taking it a lot serious now. Because I think it went from fun to understanding the impact.
Mm-hmm,
and that's the great part about podcasting is, like, you really don't know your true impact.
True.
Like, we were talking just a little earlier, like, looking at the charts, seeing that we're in, like, Dominican Republic, we're in Finland. We're in, like, Trinidad and Tobago. Like, wait, what? You look at your analytics on YouTube, and you're seeing how global you are. And this is all from a podcast that you have now entered the world of being a global brand.
Mm-hmm.
Like, talk about how simple that is, but where people start overthinking it. Like, you have a podcast, you are almost a step away from being a global brand.
Oh, most definitely. I mean, it's now to where you put out the thoughts and conversations that you're having with your friends, but except now you're sharing those thoughts just out there into the podcast sphere, and people have the ability to tap in, especially when we talk about SEO and how we title episodes, because if somebody's struggling with how to get over FOMO, and they just search how to get over FOMO, then they type it into the podcast search, they're going to get episodes. And they type it on YouTube, they're going to get some other stuff.
Yep.
So it's just understanding that the thoughts that you had before, and you might put those into a vacuum by being at the crib just talking, now you're going out there. So don't devalue what you have to offer the world. And how your thought, how your perspective, how you're feeling can really change somebody's situation based on the experience that you have you shared.
Wow. Good. I'm just listening like, yo, that's deep.
You want me to keep asking?
Yeah, please do. Please do. I got caught off guard. I was like, yo, that's real.
Okay. So let's talk about money.
Okay.
Right? We got to talk about money.
Yeah, yeah.
There are different ways you can make money from podcasting. So kind of break that down for the people. Like for us, we're getting into community. We got sponsorships. We do affiliates. But kind of break that down from your lens of how to make money from podcasting, because though it shouldn't be the main motive, it is a factor.
Yeah. It is a factor because, so I'm going to say this first part, and I'm going to get into that. It's the main factor because a lot of people might do podcasting for the love starting out, right?
Yeah.
But then when they get to like 2 years, it's like, okay, I need to make some money so I can pay for this hosting, if anything, right? If anything. But when we start talking about money from my lens, and one of my clients is actually here. Well, my community is here, my Get Paid With Podcasting community. But I was talking with, his name's RJ Zimmerman. Shout out to RJ, the host of the Untapped Keg podcast.
Okay.
Where he talked about sobriety and mental health. And he said, when I heard your podcast, and then he hopped on a webinar, then he signed up for my program.
Yep.
Right? So as you're establishing your authority in your niche for your industry, you can have 10 people that hear the episode, and you got 2-3 people that make the decision that I want to learn more. I want to invest. So, you know, you can have a program built on the back of that. In addition to that, then I also have partnered with Castos. I'm not sure if y'all are familiar with Castos, but they do the private podcast. Like, that's their their calling card.
Okay.
I've created an audio book to my podcasting book that I put out through Castos. It's an audio book, but if we frame it in terms of podcasting, it's a private podcast. So, you know, you can set up a subscription for it, or it can be a one-time pay, and they pay and they get access to it. But then, in addition to that, so we got, you can create a book. Create a book. Go on Canva. Take 7 questions that people have always asked you. you can either type up what the responses are, or you can transcribe it, pop that in Canva, save it as a PDF, you print out an ebook for $3.99.
Wow, that's good. Yeah, I see a question in the chat there. It says you don't suggest Anchor. So which podcasting platform do you recommend podcasters use?
It depends on what you want out of a platform. I have about four that I like. So my podcast now is hosted on PodPal, and I partner with them because I met them a couple years ago. But I like their platform for starting out newbie podcasters, because if you look on the backside, they walk you through each step, and they have a percentage bar that loads. So on the backside, it's showing you, you know, in terms of organizational and structure for those type people, it lays that out. It's like, okay, 50%, 100%, you need to do this, you need to do that. So I host with PodPal, and I recommend them for starting out podcasters. But if you're somebody who's like, I'm really gearing my podcast towards monetization, then I would say check out Captivate. Because Captivate, that you can print out like a sponsorship type kit deal based on your analytics and stuff, all in their platform. So
really?
So it depends on what you want. Like, it really depends on what you want. And then there's Sounder. And then Sounder, they do the transcription for SEO. And then, like I said, Castos. I love Castos because I'm doing the audiobook, did the audiobook with them, and the private podcast piece is a whole different, it's a whole different beast, because you pay for the hosting, but they're not taking a percentage like the Apple when you do your private podcast with them or the subscription with them.
Hey, I'm reading that comment right there. Sorry.
Shout out to the after show, but we're about to make some changes because of that right there.
Yeah, I love that though. It says, sorry, why is this guy a volunteer and not a speaker?
Thank you.
Yeah. No, I agree. This man need to be on stage here whenever this happens again.
I got to burn out here in a second.
Yeah, he's volunteering, so we got to go.
I got to burn
but
out.
But the thing is that, and we mentioned, I don't know if I said it on my live or we said it here, right? What's wrong? The thing is that the experts, the people you really need to talk to, are actually not on stage, right?
Ooh, that's a bar.
That what we listen, and I was really honest about it. I was like, I'm not learning as much from the stage than what I'm learning when I have conversations out here.
True.
Right? Because the real people who are doing the work, not saying they're not, but the real people who are like, super research, everything like that in the trenches, you learn more from them than necessarily some of the experts there, because they're only going to give you so much. Where if I had a conversation with you, like just in this live, right, you're willing to give out more and more information. They're allotted a certain amount of time, they're asked certain questions, and that's it. That's not anything close to near what we need. So that's why it's important to come to some of these events. Because you learn more from the networking, you learn more from talking to other people outside than necessarily even the speakers that you get from inside.
True story. And it's because, and it's also, and y'all talk, you talked about this on the episode, I believe, with Shans, because it's to the point to where the people who are actually in the trenches, they're more connected with what the need is versus somebody who is, you know, the head of X podcast company, because their focus is, okay, bottom line, bringing in talent, all this other stuff. And our focus is making sure that we get stuff that works right now. Right. Tried and true for an audience of 5 people, 10 people, 30 people. They looking at 3,000, 300,000, 3 million, right? So it's just one of those things, also looking from the lens and also just the perspective of the individual giving the information.
I like it. I know you gotta go. I appreciate you so much.
Indeed.
We still gotta kick it though.
I appreciate y'all.
Yeah,
I got you. I got my camera and stuff. After today, we can sit down and do the interview. I got my camera. I got my mics. It's in my backpack right now.
Wow.
That's fine. We'll do it.
That sounds like
I'm
a plan.
Hit you. Okay.
Let's do
it. I'm out. I appreciate y'all.
Indeed, appreciate it.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
So that was Jonathan. That's one of my guys, right?